This marks my 23rd NAB in a row. Clearly, I started attending when I was 5. Now, if you can join the fun in person, or even better, if you can, here's a tasty little snippet from one of my sessions about Illustrator for motion design. I'll show you how to effortlessly bring vectors into life in After Effects without setting a single keyframe. Yes, really? Plus, how to extrude and animate them like a seasoned pro in Cinema 4D. Ready to dive in? Let's make some magic. So I'll start off with this illustration that I've prepared ahead of time. Notice that I have a few layers, and the easiest way to push these vectors into After Effects is, of course, with Overlord. So I'll create an After Effects composition from this artboard, and then I'll return back to Illustrator, select all the layers, then click on Push Selection. And this, of course, is going to bring back After Effects to the front, and everything is basically ready to animate. So first I'll rename this composition Bikers, just because I'm a compulsive motion designer, and then I'll start animating those layers. I'll start with the background. Notice that everything was built automatically using shape layers here in After Effects, including live text. All right, so selecting the background, I'll go to the effects and presets, and I'll open up the animation presets, and inside the behaviors folder, I'll double click on drift over time. I'll change the direction to 90 degrees and the speed to negative 20. And this is going to move the background to the left. All right, let's do something similar to the bikers themselves. I'll start with the main bike. Actually, I'll select both of them and double click to apply the drift over time behavior, which is basically some expression magic baked into After Effects that will help you to drive those layers. So let's select the main bike. Again, I'll change the direction to 90 degrees. And this one wants to be, let's say, 80 in terms of its speed. And then the girl is going to bike a bit more quicker. So let's change the direction, but we'll give her a bit more speed, so 160. And this is how it works so far. All right, we are getting somewhere. Now we can animate the text. Now, because this is a live text, I can just select the text layer. Let's just hide the properties panel and look for something that works for this line. So I happen to know that something with this rain preset, I'll select 3D rain in by word, is actually going to work quite nicely. So this is how it looks. And I'm just going to place it over here where the animation ends, select the three bicycle words, and replace this one with another preset. I'll start to type the word slide in, and I'll go with slide in by line. Now I'm going to select the layer, press U to see the keyframes, and maybe drag them over here. And if I want, I can also extend the duration of this composition to, let's say, 7 seconds. And you'll understand why, because I actually want to sing something for you. Now, the reason I can't play the original Queen song is, of course, because of copyright. But I have this little Freddy, which is going to help me perform it for you. So let's see how this works. I'm going to maximize this frame, and then I'll preview and sing it for you. I want to ride my bicycle, bicycle, bicycle. Almost. All right, so this is how easy it is to animate vectors inside After Effects coming from Illustrator without a single keyframe. Now let's push it further and see how we can transform vectors to 3D, extrude them, and animate them flawlessly with zero knowledge in 3D. To pull it off, I'm going to use Cinema 4D. So here is an empty document. I'll go to File, Merge Objects, and I'm going to use this articulated document that is an AI document. And it's not artificial intelligence. This time it is Adobe Illustrator. All right, I'll click Open, and I'm going to say OK for this message. And after a few moments, I'm going to see this over here. I'll press H to frame this, and then I'll tap the letter 3, actually the digit 3, and just orbit around the scene, just creating something a little bit more interesting in terms of our starting point. I'm also going to go to Filter and switch off the work plane so it won't be in our way. Now, this is a cool feature inside Cinema 4D. It can basically work with native Adobe Illustrator files. So all I need to do is just play with this object here. So let's start by extruding it to maybe 3. And then I'm going to visit the cups section and change the size to, let's say, 0.3. And already this looks really promising, but we can make it even better. We can come back to the object and we can animate those things. So let's go to around 75 here, and then I'll create a keyframe for the path spread. Go all the way back to the beginning and change this value to maybe 1. And this is going to separate everything. Of course, I need to create a keyframe over here. And you can see if I'll scrub the timeline, how this is going to work. Of course, now we need to frame it and make it more beautiful because this is, of course, 3D. So I'll start by creating a camera and then I will look through the camera and frame my scene. Let's go to the end. So maybe around 75. Similarly to where we created the keyframes, again, pressing 1, 2, and 3 will allow you to choose something interesting in terms of the angle, and maybe zoom in so we can see the entire world in its almost full glory. Then I'll create a keyframe for the camera, basically record the active object. I'm going to the coordinates just to show you that we have keyframes now for everything. Then let's go to the beginning and just pick a different angle. So maybe zoom out a little bit and change the rotation. Maybe start from this angle underneath, make it a little bit more mysterious and create another keyframe. And just like that, we have some really nice animation that is basically bringing all of those individual paths from Illustrator and extruding them and animating it over here. Now we can make it even more beautiful by going to the asset browser. I'm already inside this HDR Eyes studio, and this is something that comes with Cinema 4D, basically an HDR eye light. I'm just going to drag it over here. And to show you how this looks, I'll start my IPR render so you can get a sense of how this is looking when it's fully texturized. Actually, not texturized, the textures are from Illustrator, but we have nice shadows and everything. And if we're talking about textures, let's say that we don't like these colors. Well, this is super easy. This is still connected. It's almost like a dynamic link relationship with Illustrator. So I'll go to the object after selecting the document over here and then click on Open in AI. This is going to open it in Adobe Illustrator. I'll select all the layers here, Command A, and I'm going to use the recolor artwork to choose something different. Now you can use generative recolor if you really want to work with AI inside AI, or you can just take this and pick something different. Let's go with this theme. Command S to save the document. I'll return back to Cinema and then I'll need to update it by clicking on this little guy, and it's going to read everything that I've created inside Illustrator and show us the result. And all we need to do right now is just render it and that's it. So hopefully there are a few takeaways from this and you learned something new that you can use in your work. I really hope that you are going to visit me at NAB. Come and say hello. And if you don't, I'm going to see you here on YouTube really soon. Thank you so much for watching. Take care and goodbye.